Welcome to the City of Reading Zoning Hearing Board meeting for September the 9th. I'd like to welcome all of you. If you have any electronic equipment, would you please turn it off? I'm going to ask the board members to introduce themselves from left to right.
Jared Bartz, member of the board.
Jeff Picone, member of the board.
Bill Harst, member of the board.
Tom Fox, member of the board.
Phil Rubina, member of the board.
Craig Piper, zoning administrator.
Steve Price, solicitor to the board.
Okay, thank you. We only have one case to be heard this evening. It is 1129 Chestnut Street. It's appeal 2015-28. Is the applicant here? Okay, would you come forward and be seated, please? I don't know if you can probably hear her from there.
I'll let you know.
All right, that sounds good. Okay, would you swear in our zoning officer, please?
You swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and
nothing but the truth. I do.
Has notice for this appeal been given?
It has.
Okay. Mr. Price.
Thanks. Exhibit number one will be notice of appeal. Exhibit number two will be proof of posting of the notice. Exhibit number three will be proof of publication of the notice. Exhibit number four will be the application, including all of its attachments. And exhibit number five is the zoning ordinance of the City of Reading as amended. The way we conduct hearings here is I'll walk the applicant through some testimony. She can add whatever she'd like to add. She'll be subject to examination by myself, members of the board, and anybody in the audience who has standing to participate. By that, if you live next door or across the street and you want to ask questions of the applicant, you'll have to get up, state your name and address, and then we'll determine whether or not you can participate. Does anybody have any questions? The record will reflect there are no questions. Okay, we can start.
Okay, would you swear in our applicant, please?
Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and help you God?
Okay, thank you.
So it's P-E-A-R-E-D-E-S?
All right, Ms. Paredes, you have to answer yes or no, or okay, you just can't nod your head because she's trying to take a record here, all right? You filed an appeal to request a variance, is that correct?
Correct.
And 1129 Chestnut Street, do you have a lease for that property or do you own it?
A lease.
And the landlord has authorized you to seek this variance?
Yes.
And the property, it's been the prior, had received prior approval to be used as a multi-service building, correct?
Yes.
And that's for notary and things like that, correct? Correct?
Yeah.
And how long have you operated that multi-service there?
It's been like almost 2 years.
2 years. And at some point you started to actually sell things like automotive supplies, tires, things like that, correct?
Yes.
And you never obtained zoning approval, correct?
Correct.
And then you also started to operate a pawn shop there, correct?
Correct.
And you don't have a license to operate a pawn shop, do you? And at some point, the zoning officer came to your establishment and told you that you were in violation and you applied for this variance, correct?
Yes.
And you've since ceased selling car automotive parts and quit ceased being a pawn shop.
Right.
Okay. Now, when you entered into the lease for 1129 Chestnut Street, you understood the restrictions on what you could do there?
Yes.
Okay. And you're able to operate a multi-service there. The only reason that you were selling automotive parts and whatnot was to make more money?
No, I had thought because the people previous from us, they had said they got approved to buy, sell, and trade. So I thought it was sell and trade.
No, sorry.
So I thought it was okay for me to do it, you know what I mean? I didn't mean it in a way to violate anything.
But if you just operate it as a multi-service shop, you can make a living there, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. I don't have any other questions.
How about members of the board? Anybody have any questions?
Are you still operating the multi-service?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, one other question. If you, items that you would sell that wouldn't be automotive, or related to the pawn. What other items were you selling?
Cell phone cases, cell phones, headphones, tablets.
Are you talking about computer tablets?
Yeah.
The iPad type thing?
Yeah, iPad. Yeah.
Okay.
cameras.
And if the board was so inclined to grant your relief, but limit it to only selling the items that you just mentioned, no more automotive, no more pawn shop, that kind of stuff, you'd be agreeable to that?
I do want to sell some, like car radios and some car parts, not rims or none of that. That's fine. I'm not worried about that. But you know, people come in and they look for car parts and.
What kind of car parts?
Speakers and car radios, stuff like that.
I don't know.
So you're talking basically accessories to automobile, not the main things that engine required type
right.
things.
Yeah, just radios and speakers. That's mostly the cars that are there.
Question for Mr. Pfeiffer. Car radios and speakers, is that acceptable?
I would say it's in line with the other electronics that they're looking to sell.
Okay. Are you going to be selling any groceries or anything like that?
No.
Okay, good. All right, anybody in the audience have a question of this applicant? Just a question about what's going on there. Okay, seeing none. Again, anybody have any questions? All right. Anybody in the audience who has standing, would you like to testify for the granting of this application? Anybody want to testify against granting the application? Okay. We're going to take this under consideration, and we'll issue a decision at next month's meeting. You need not be present. It will be mailed to you. And I'm just simply going to say, I'm not directing this necessarily to you, but we've had these discussions before. Whenever you get a property and operate anything in the city, don't depend on somebody else to tell you what you can or can't do with a property. Go to the right people in the city, code services, zoning. They will walk you through it. They want to be friendly to businesses because we understand those are people's livelihoods and they supply jobs for the city. But do not depend on real estate people and don't depend on friends and neighbors to tell you what you can or can't do. It saves you a lot of grief and embarrassment and it just works better for everybody. So having said that, I will.
Just one other comment. Are you aware, ma'am, that you are not to operate a pawn shop?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Fox. I appreciate that. All right, that closes this appeal, and we'll issue the decision at next month's meeting, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
Okay. All right, you can have a seat. Thank you. We had seven decisions rendered from last month's meeting. And the first one is 400 South 6th Street. It's appeal 2015-12.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
Make motion.
Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Ayes have it.
Okay. The next matter, 229 Lancaster Avenue. 231 Lancaster Avenue, 238 Brookline Street, and it was appeal 2015-22.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Any questions or comments? All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Ayes have it.
16 North 8th Street. It's appeal 2015-19.
Is there a motion to approve the requested relief subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
A motion.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Ayes have it.
Okay. 230 Grace Street, aka 234 Grace Street. Appeal 2015-24.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
So moved.
Okay. Second.
All in favor, say aye.
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 All opposed?
Ayes have it.
Okay.
1126 Oley Street, Appeal 2015-25.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
So move.
Second.
Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
1928 North 13th Street, Appeal 2015-26.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the written conditions set forth in the written decision?
Motion.
Second.
Any questions? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
850 Laurel Street, Appeal 2015-27.
Is there a motion to approve the relief requested subject to the conditions set forth in the written decision?
So move.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay, thank you. And that concludes our meeting for this month. We'll see you the second Wednesday in October.
Question.